My book's called Shapely Ankle Preferr'd, A History of the Lonely Hearts Ad. Lonely Hearts ads actually go back much further than most people realise, so I found them right back to 1695, which means you get these really hilarious and sometimes rather heartbreaking ads all the way through the 18th, 19th and 20th centuries. So, for example, one of my favourite ads is one from 1720 that runs, "Man seeks wife, must have shapely ankle and good cow management skills." So really it's a history of dating and marriage, but done through Lonely Hearts ads. It's probably no coincidence that I started writing the book just after I got married, because in essence, the book's about human mate choice, sort of what men look for in a woman, what women look for in a man, and how that's changed or not changed over the years. There are a lot of contemporary resonances in the book. You know, these days we're all being told how everyone is doing internet dating, but actually the idea of advertising for love is by no means a new thing. People have been doing it for 300 years. Particularly the reasons people advertise, that hasn't changed at all. You know, it's all about, oh, I've just moved to the big city, I don't know many people here, I work very hard so I don't have time to make friends. That's hardly changed at all. Some of the reasons, or some of the things people look for in a partner have changed. So in the 18th century, there was a lot of must be a non-dancer, must have a well-shaped head, must be excellent at looking after pigs. You know, you don't get that so much these days in internet ads. But actually, there are a lot of things that have changed very little in terms of what men look for in a woman, what women look for in a man, you know, the kind of partner that we want to spend the rest of our life with. That's actually changed very little in many ways. The research for the book involved a lot of trawling through newspapers for days and days on end, because really what amazed me was the sheer number of Lonely Hearts ads, and you know, 99% of these ads have never seen the light of day since they first appeared on the front page of the Times, as it were. So they really are an amazingly rich source of evidence about what we all look for in a partner, or at least pretend to look for in a partner when it's there in black ink in the newspaper. I also tracked down a lot of real life stories, you know, what happened next. So for example, the case of Jack and Gertie Burnicle, who met in Portsmouth in 1895 through a Lonely Hearts ad and then lived happily ever after. So, you know, there really are some very romantic tales in there. In essence, I suppose the book's really about how humans fall in love. So, you know, if you're in love, if you're looking for love and want a few top tips on the past, then I think you'll really like this book. It's got all the key ingredients. It's got romance, it's got heartbreak, comedy, tragedy, the whole shebang. It's really the perfect read for Valentine's Day.